Hello, my name's Kent. I'm the creative specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to show how to use the particle effects component. Here's an example of what you can do with particle effects, which is the type of animation with lots of tiny objects and randomized realistic motion that's not really suitable for timeline animation. Snow and rain are examples, and they can be used to create some interesting video-like effects. This example uses multiple particle effects for the fire, smoke, and stars. You'll find this in the Components panel, inside the Miscellaneous folder. Drag particle effects to the stage. Now you can change the size and position. And with the Selection tool, double-click to open the Control panel. To get started, drag one of these presets onto the stage. We have snow and rain, a few sizes of fire, and steam and smoke. I'll use snow. Now I see two bounding boxes on stage. The heavy gray one is the size of the component we just set, and this blue one is the particle emitter. That's the area in which the particles are spawned. It can be resized and moved, but not outside the component boundaries. So if we wanted the snowflakes to all be created above our dock, we'd have to make the component height a little taller so I can move this emitter up. On the left, I'll see snow in the Layers panel, and I can drag in more presets. Reorder, hide, and delete them. Note when hidden, the effects are not removed from your published document, they're just invisible, but still consuming resources, so you don't want to leave these hidden in your final files. I also have my regular library panel on the left where I can access all items in my doc, like images, but I would only add them here if that sandwiching is critical to my effect. Otherwise, it's best to add background images in the main timeline, not this dialogue, where I'll have more control over scaling and binding and get better performance. And on the right is my Properties panel, where most of the work is done. You'll also see some advanced settings. It's important to know these same controls exist for all presets, so you can start with snow and adjust these values to end up with fire or smoke. I can also change a preset with this pulldown. We can control the number of particles shown at once, and the minimum and maximum sizes of the particles, which start randomly between these values and get bigger or smaller depending on the size rate in the advanced settings. For Sprite, we can select the particle object and even set a custom image. Now I can select one from my library or desktop. We also have speed, opacity, and direction controls. At this point, I'll preview to see the effect, and we can make changes here to see the results in real time. In the advanced properties, we have the emitter fields, which just correspond to the emitter size on stage, so I can set this to 50% and now it's half as wide as the component. Next, there's size rate and rate controls for color and opacity. These all adjust the speed of changing to the min-max values set in the basic properties. Positive values here will change towards the maximum, and negative values change toward the minimum. With one of the default sprites selected, we can control the colors, the change rate, or randomize colors. Autoplay means the effect starts immediately, but I could turn this off to control the effect from a custom event on a button, for example. Loop means the effect continually spawns new particles. Skip forward lets me begin with the screen filled with particles rather than waiting for them to fill in. Acceleration can be used to create gravity effects. And last are the turbulence controls, which should be used with caution because they can lead to overloading and low frame rates. Back in Design View, if I click outside the stage area so nothing's selected, I see the autoplay duration, which is usually 30 seconds max for ads, but I can change it or uncheck to play forever. So I'll save this, and back in my main timeline, one last thing I want to point out is I can mask these effects. If I right-click, add a gradient mask, and change its direction, I can fade out the particles as they fall. That does it for the particle effects component. Thanks for watching.